Hey, happy Saturday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. Got a huge update on the chance for our severe weather and what's happening in the tropics. We do have chances for tornadoes for today, and it's going to grow into tomorrow, especially for Texas and Oklahoma. You can't rule out a couple of tornadoes, but this is going to bring damage and winds, chances for hail, as this congeals all together towards a potential squall line that's still forming up, bringing damage and winds on the northern half by Ohio Valley to Great Lakes, and chances for more tornadoes on the southern half with more damage and winds and hail as well. Then we're going to be dealing with what's forming up over here in the Caribbean. So we did have this disturbance a couple of hours ago form over the northern Atlantic. It actually taken the name of Patty. So this formation down here would be Raphael. And showing it could get a surface low, a circulation trying to form down here. All this blue, it represents convection. A lot of lift, a lot of bursting in the thunderstorms. You see over here, they're inhibiting a lot of dry air. That's why you're not seeing a lot of bursting in those neither. And what's over here by the Greater Antilles, eventually it's hitting a lot of dry air as well, but we still could have this one come in from the MDR, and look how it's losing a lot of its precipitation from yesterday and a lot of dry air. This is going to have to combat as it comes in. So I'm going to show you the latest information in this video, including what's going on with our severe weather. This is very beginning of November. We are on the 2nd of November, and we have another strong storm coming behind this one, a little bit further to the north, but it looks stronger to me. Now you see you're already getting the flash flood alerts going over here from New Mexico. This is going to be a growing threat as it comes through the south central as well. Now you can see the storms are training in from New Mexico, coming into the panhandle of Texas. This is going to affect a little bit of western Oklahoma as well. This is bringing your chances for your damage and winds, but this is also going to add up to a lot of flooding after these storms and rounds of storms just comes in this area day after day, getting really heavy, especially for northern Texas, Oklahoma, eastern Kansas, northwestern Arkansas, and through Missouri on its way through Illinois. So it's still bringing a lot of flooding with this also. Now we'll go through the information with you, but for today you do have your tornado threat. It is growing a little bit more into Oklahoma with 2%. You get the 5% over here by Midland, Texas. But as you go into tomorrow, this is where it's going to grow. You do have some convection over here going towards Kansas, a chance for a tornado, but the biggest chance is going to be for northern Texas and for Oklahoma for this tornadoes to form up for tomorrow. Then as you go into Monday, this is where your severe weather grows even more. So for today, your chances for tornadoes, your 2% and your 5%. Here's your cities and states at risk so far. We also have the wind threat for today and the hail threat, chances for significant severe, even chances for large hail, especially as is going towards Midland. So here's your cities and states at risk for the hail threat for today. And for your wind threat, here's your cities and states at risk also for today. National Weather Service has scattered strong severe storms will be possible later today and tonight, primarily from the Permian Basin and South Plains into southwest Oklahoma during the late afternoon and early evening. Now this will mainly bring isolated damaging gusts and marginally severe hail with a low wind threat for embedded QLCS mesovortex tornadoes, quasi-linear convective system tornadoes in that front line of storms. Hail and tornado potential will be greatest farther southwest today over parts of western Texas and extreme southeastern New Mexico. This is also where instability should be the greatest and with a favorable wind shear. So it should support probabilities for tornadoes, large to significant severe, 2+ inch hail possible. So you're going to have these storms rumbling all the way to about noontime, bringing you some chances for hail, even some damage and winds possibility with that. But once you go in the afternoon, then you start getting these embedded cells that's in this line, plus what's pop up with these discrete cells from New Mexico coming to western Texas. This is where your biggest chance for your tornado threat will grow as it comes through the evening and bring you chances for hail and chances for tornadoes. And then further to the east, you still can't rule out a quasi-linear convective system line where they have a chance for embedded tornadoes in there, but more likely will merge together and become a damaging wind event eventually later on this afternoon. But you have to watch out for the chances for the tornadoes to grow on the western side and the chance for those before they come into that line to form up possibly before it becomes a damaging wind event. Then you're going to go overnight into tomorrow, see the bow and line segments, bring your chances for damaging winds with these thunderstorms, and then tomorrow is going to grow. Tomorrow is going to be the same thing, but a little bit further towards the east while you get this group of storms coming over, bringing you heavy rainfall, bringing you that training of flooding. You're going to get another line of storms coming with that dry line as you go through tomorrow evening. Now, this is bringing chances for damage and winds, but you could get some discrete cells also in front of this as this moves further towards the east. So watch out for your chances for a tornado. A brief tornado could spin up. Most of this looks like it will be damage and winds, but you do have the chances for a discrete cell to pop up as you're going through for tomorrow as well. And then it's going to turn into a damage and wind event. Then we're going to get that linear storm of a squall line. And on the southern side, still could get chances for tornadoes, but it will be damaging winds on the northern side. So for tomorrow, for Sunday, your tornado threat has grown even more. You have the 2% and you have the 5% chance for tornadoes. So far, here's your cities and states at risk for that. You also have chances for the damaging winds and chances for hail as well. So here's your cities and states at risk for the hail threat for tomorrow, for Sunday. And here's your cities and states at risk for the hail threat for tomorrow. National Weather Service has scattered severe storms are possible in multiple rounds from midday Sunday through Sunday night. The most likely affected areas include parts of Oklahoma into north and west central Texas. Tornadoes, damaging winds, and large hail may occur. Also showing on CSU, Colorado State University, that our threat for tornadoes could increase for today, bringing a 2% all the way into southern Kansas and our 5% growing into Oklahoma as well. And for tomorrow, instead over here for the South Central, could move into the Central Plains with a 5% growing for Kansas, Western Missouri, and Western Arkansas, and the 2% going all the way up possibly into Nebraska and Iowa. Plus, as we go Sunday into Monday, this is where we're going to get that surface low forming up, and it's going to be more of a dangerous threat for damaging winds and tornadoes on the eastern side of this as this goes further into the afternoon and congeals to a squall line, bringing you chances for damaging winds on the southern side with a couple QLCS tornadoes you cannot rule out, chances for hail. But on the northern side, you have strong winds aloft, and this is going to bring you chances for damaging winds as you go from Monday into Tuesday, and you get a surface low forming up right here by Iowa. That would make it more severe over here for Illinois and maybe even southern Wisconsin with some damaging winds and storms that forms up for Tuesday. But showing for your winds aloft as you go into tomorrow, into Monday, this is where it starts raising up. Monday into Monday evening, overnight into Tuesday is where you have strong winds aloft on that squall line that's coming up with that surface low just forming right here. This is bringing more of a threat overnight Monday into Tuesday with some damaging winds that could be coming out of that. So far, National Weather Service has increased it 5% all the way up towards Illinois in a big area of 15%. So far, here's your cities and states at risk for the severe weather for Monday. And they have it as scattered severe thunderstorms are possible on Monday into Monday night from parts of North and East Texas to Missouri. Tornadoes and damaging winds should be the main hazards. Still showing there's a possibility that the instability will be too weak to carry your tornado threat further north, but it's already in a bigger area. More like a focus corridor of greater tornado wind potential may become clear in later outlooks. Right now, they have the tornado threat may peak during the evening from Texas towards Missouri with time on Monday night. Showing the damage and winds with GFS will be that 40, but start growing towards that 50 in that orange from the winds aloft as it starts getting that strengthening low pressure, the cyclogenesis. And you can see that next wave coming through right by Florida, but look how it curves by and then it dissipates. That's because it's getting hit with that shear, almost like it's getting strengthened for nothing. But if this was a little further towards the east, it would do some kind of landfall on the edge of western Florida. But so far, it would show weak. It might try and strengthen over Cuba, but it would weaken because of landfall after that. I'll show you the latest updates. But when you look with the area right here, just where the winds are, whether it's weak or strong, you can see with the Euro, they're showing almost the same pathway on that storm system. Now, both of them is showing that it could strengthen up a little bit, but majority of them show it will stay weak because of the shear and the environment that it's about to go into. It has a good environment, but if it don't start get any kind of strength in the Caribbean and tap into the deep ocean heat, it will not be intensified for as it goes through the Gulf. But still showing to Euro that it will try and do what Milton did, come all the way over. As it's coming over, peeling off from this trough, moisture and moisture just keeps peeling off from this system as it goes all the way over to the southern half of the Gulf. Maybe something we'll try and form over there later. That is literally 9-10 days away from that. But you can see, like I showed you in the beginning of the video, all that heavy rainfall that is expected. This is only for the next 72 hours by the time you go through Tuesday morning. Very heavy rainfall coming. Now, a lot of this is needed, but this is so much on dry land. This will bring some serious flooding, especially over here for northern Texas, Oklahoma, southeastern Kansas, western Arkansas, and western Missouri. A big area for serious flooding. When these storms, this train over the same areas for hours and hours, this is the outcome. Now, when you look for the next 10 days, which will move around, you can see with the Euro that this does add up to a lot of rainfall from the south central all the way towards the central plains and the Great Lakes, upper Midwest. But you can also see as this wave tries to form in the Caribbean, multiple waves, and it gets pulled to the west, you can see how you get heavy rainfall of some tropical moisture that pulls around Florida and southeast. That's because we actually have two systems that's trying to form up, and one just stays weak, but it brings rainfall, a lot of tropical moisture for y'all, while the other one goes to the west and maybe do something later on. Now, they still have this area right here of disturbance that's going to still merge with what forms over here. And when it does form, since Patty took this name, this would be Raphael. And what forms potentially after that, we will discuss later. Up to 80% now in 7 days, 60% in the next 48 hours. And still showing it will generally go northward to northwestward over the central and western Caribbean Sea. Still showing by the Euro, this will go and try and curve something weak or a piece of it, get ripped off by Florida. Then it'll go further towards that west and try and break off again towards Louisiana, then go further towards the west. While you have something that tries to form up as we get that next piece of energy. And you can see this as you go 4 to 5 days. This is where it goes all the way towards Florida, and it tries to get a piece breaking off going towards Florida while this continues to go 7 days around to the west. Then it tries again to break off a piece and maybe try and go towards Louisiana. More likely will bring more moisture, more precipitation while this generally goes to the west. You see how it's trying to go towards Louisiana while it goes towards the west. Showing in the ensembles that literally by the time you get towards Sunday evening, maybe even Monday morning, that we will have tropical development formation. And as you go a little bit closer towards Jamaica, this is where it starts strengthening up from a tropical depression to a tropical storm, trying to become a strong tropical storm as it goes through the Western Caribbean. And literally, once you go towards 5 days, this is where things change. You can see where the outcomes are. Could be a little bit further wide, could be a little bit towards Florida, but it's pretty much in agreement right here on Western Caribbean. Now, once you go past 5 days, it could break off towards Florida. There's a few ensembles showing that. Majority shows that it will go all the way towards the center of the Gulf of Mexico. Then it'll go more to the west, showing less of a chance that something could break off by this time. The trough will not catch it, and it will just go into the west and try and break off again towards Texas as it goes towards the western side. So I'm still showing it will try multiple times to break off as it goes west, showing that it will more than likely be right here, right around 4 to 5 days though. So we still have time to discuss it. You can see right here with the Euro in 5 days, showing the Euro was correct with the placement of that system coming in, showing that this will get lingering right into the Western Caribbean on this point, while we still get some convection of something trying to form over here by Puerto Rico still. Now, when you go through the multiple models that we have, so this is a Euro right at 5 days. That's right at 5 days when you look at the Canadian right at 5 days and the GFS right at 5 days. So the majority of them is showing that the census will be right around here in 5 days, showing it can be anywhere from a strong tropical depression to maybe a strong tropical storm that will go in and out of strength. So when you look with the Euro, you can see as it tries to go that way, it gets ripped off. Some of the precipitation gets ripped off of that storm. Then it goes west again. When you look with the Canadian, it tries to bring it on shore with all that while a lot of it gets ripped off from that trough. You see how it has a grab of it right there? gets ripped off from the shear, and it just comes in as something very weak, bringing you that extra rainfall. GFS shows almost the same thing, gets ripped off. You see how you get all that ripped off and sheared off of the system. Then as it goes west, this other one tries to form up. Then the trough grabs it and pulls it to the north, to the northeast, somewhat breaks it down to where it's trying to be a hurricane, and eventually gets broken down to nothing, just a tropical depression that gets sheared and broken apart. And that second one weakens down as well. Try and see a trend you can see with the spire, that it shows that it will get some rotation, it will strengthen up maybe to a strong tropical storm as it's passing by Jamaica, trying to become a hurricane. And as it goes towards the west, it becomes a hurricane. That's according to the spire. Weakens over landfall, but still a hurricane in the Gulf of Mexico, going to that westward push, getting sheared and getting weakened down to nothing. Getting strong and impacting multiple people. Could impact Jamaica, the Cayman Islands, Cuba, maybe the Florida Keys. But after that, no more impacts but heavy rainfall and flooding potentially. Look at the trend. Look at the Euro control member showing it very weak as it comes by Jamaica, bringing y'all some maybe some flooding as it comes by. Curving around, getting peeled off. A lot of that precipitation trying to form up in the southern Gulf and go up towards southern Texas and get stopped. And the Canadian trying to strengthen up. It shows the same strength as the Euro, something weak by Jamaica, as it goes generally to the west. Tries to strengthen up, but it gets sheared so much and it just dies off, brings flooding. And you can see the outcome with the GFS, what I just showed you. Agreeing with the spire, it could become that tropical storm, a strong tropical storm towards Jamaica. So that is kind of trending right there. It's 50-50. Showing the same path right over Cuba, Western Cayman Islands, goes into the Gulf, gets strong for nothing in the Gulf, and weakens down and just no impacts. So let's bring in another one. Here's the icon. Agreeing with the Euro that it will be something weak for Jamaica, going to the west, staying something weak. The Euro AI shows it weak for Jamaica as it comes across Cuba, land interaction. Nothing. Gets sheared to death. So the next name on the list is Raphael. And if we get another one behind that, it would be Sarah. Now before you go, real quick, a quick word from Moses. Deuteronomy 12, 28 through 32. Observe and hear all these words which I command thee, that it may go well with thee and with thy children after thee forever, when thou doest that which is good and right in the sight of the Lord thy God. When the Lord thy God shall cut off the nations from before thee, whither thou goest to possess them, and thou succeedest them and dwellest in their land, take heed to thyself, that thou be not snared by following them, after that they be destroyed from before thee, and that thou inquire not after their gods, saying, how did these nations serve their gods? Even so will I do likewise. Thou shalt not do so unto the Lord thy God, for every abomination to the Lord, which he hateth, have they done unto their gods. For even their sons and their daughters they have burnt in the fire to their gods. What thing soever I command you, observe to do it, thou shalt not add thereto, nor diminish from it. Amen. All glory goes to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life. And forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. Watch out for the chance of these tornadoes as growing from tonight into tomorrow.